Hello everyone, Kevin here, and I want to welcome you to this Gobbler's Roost adventure. Now, today's video is the first time I got out on my 8-day Stone Point deer hunt. I had planned to get out hunting right away after work on Friday, but it was raining, and it was raining Saturday morning also. But as soon as the rain stopped, I got out. I have a small window of opportunity because it's supposed to start raining out again late Saturday night, all day Sunday, and into Monday. Sunday's going to be a washout. I'll wind up spending the day in the shop working on deer calls probably. But anyways, I had this window of opportunity, so I took it. If you're interested in seeing what happened, come out along. That felt good. I always try and stretch my muscles a little bit and practice my aim once I sit down. It's late October. Be November in a couple of days. And it's been raining on the weekends. This is I have a small window here to get to hunt. It rained after work yesterday. I didn't get out. It rained all this morning. I worked in the shop. But now it's stopped. It's just kind of gray. And the forecast is telling me that I have a little window here. Just this afternoon and evening. And then tomorrow into the next day, it's going to be a total washout. So I'm kind of excited to sit here now. I just juiced the scrape out there. I'm feeling good. The deer are moving. I've been seeing deer. The rut is definitely on. So I'm going to sit here for a few hours and see if anything happens. If you're interested in sitting there and staring at this empty space out there with me, you're welcome to come along. Hopefully something will walk by and fill it up, but for most part, I'm going to sit here and stare at that empty space. darn it. It was this close. I only needed her to take two more steps. I think they're gone now. There was another one came from over there snorting. I was thinking that might have been a buck. But I never saw him. Oh, I only needed her to take two more steps. But that was the fawn. The doe was the first one that walked by. She got behind me. And she was suspicious the whole time. They couldn't smell me, but she was suspicious. I could hear her behind me stomping her foot. And that's what put the fawn on alert. That's why the fawn didn't move forward. And that's why it eventually walked off, because the doe was behind me stomping her foot. She didn't know what was wrong, but she knew something was wrong. Oh well. We just have to keep trying. Darn it, that was a nice buck. He came in right behind me. I only got a quick glimpse of him. That was the fourth deer I've seen today. The rut is on.
And there it was, folks. They came in. Oh, I needed that small doe to take just two more steps. And she would have been in good range. She would have been about 11 yards for me. What you might not have noticed was the camera angle and my angle were quite different. I was actually behind that brush out there, and I could just barely see that doe. Actually, I had seen, mostly my vision was on the first doe, the mama doe that came up, and she walked out behind me, and she stood out because there's apples over there, and that small doe, there's apples over there also where she stood. You could see her eating them, but right in the beginning, I couldn't see her, but the camera angle saw her coming in all the way. And those two doe were in front of me for almost 30 minutes. I trimmed some of it out. But it was pretty, I thought it was pretty exciting. I came close to shooting her at one point, but she turned her head back and was looking in my direction, so I couldn't draw the bow. And I thought better of it anyways once I got ready to shoot. She was about 13 yards at that time, well within my range, but I would have liked to have been a little closer to 10 yards. I wanted her to move two more steps out, And, well, as you saw, she just didn't do it. I hope you enjoyed the video. There'll be more to come. I'm Kevin, and I want to thank you for coming along on this Gobbler's Roost Adventure.